Malware authors have become creative with how they have chosen to package their payload. Office documents have been used as a common vector of entry in the following way. A Word document uses a macro to launch PowerShell and download a malicious payload, which ultimately infects the endpoint. Oftentimes, a malicious payload is found by a threat researcher outside of this original context. In order to prevent their payload from being analyzed, malware authors obfuscate the executable and institute context checks to make it terminate early during runtime. In this video, we will detail how threat researchers can use the VMRay function log to reverse engineer a payload that is discovered outside of the original context. Initially, we submit the payload to VMRay with the default settings, including a 2-minute timeout and automatic user interaction enabled. By clicking into the report, we can see that the analysis terminates early, running for only 39 seconds, over a minute short of the 2-minute timeout, and it scores low, with a 0 out of 100 VTI score. Each of these can serve as a clue that part of the runtime context is missing for this sample. From the function log, we can identify the last commands executed before the program exits. In this case, these commands include get module handle w, string compare, and string length. With this information, we can go into IDA Pro, a common disassembler, to check where these commands are located and statically analyze the code segments of this executable. With the file loaded into IDA, we can see that string compare, one of the last commands recorded in the function log, is at the end of a block of code. Directly below, we can see that there is a conditional branch between a large code segment and a jump to the end of the executable. Considering the early termination at runtime, we can infer that this large block of code is not executed. The next step for us is to investigate what is required to follow the other branch of that condition and execute the large block of code. At this point, IDA is not that useful for us. When we try to read the strings that are passed from IDA, we can see that they are unresolved and non-readable as an end user. This suggests that these strings were obfuscated by the malware author. We can confirm this by returning to the function log and searching for strings. When we do so, each of the strings appears to be heavily obfuscated. For this sample, we see one of the obfuscated strings decoded to get command line A at runtime within get proc address. Back in IDA, this is not visible, and it limits the analysis that you can do statically from the disassembler. Returning to the function log, we can now identify the condition that needs to be met in order to execute the dormant code block. From string compare, we see an empty string compared to a random string, and as they are not equal, the function returns a value of negative 1. A few lines before, we can see get command line called, which returns the path of the executable, as well as any arguments passed. Combining all of this information, we can make an educated guess that the payload requires an argument to pass the string compare condition. To test our hypothesis, we can resubmit the payload with this string in the string compare function as a command line argument. In the report, we can already see that the payload behaves differently, getting a VTI score of 85 out of 100 and running until timeout. Additionally, in the screenshot section, we can see the ransomware message prompting the end user to pay $100 worth of Bitcoin. To confirm that we have forced the dormant code segment to execute, we can download the function log of this analysis and take a look at the string compare function. With the command line argument passed, this function returns 0, indicating the strings match, and continues executing. At the bottom of the thread, the payload spawns a new process called svchost.exe, which ultimately performs the ransomware sequence, encrypting the files in the machine. By using the VMRay function log, we can analyze the runtime behavior of this payload as if it was executed in the original context, allowing a threat researcher to get insight into the TTPs used by the malware author and the IOCs generated by this payload. Thank you for watching this edition of Reversing with VMRay, discussing how you can use the VMRay function log to identify the necessary runtime environment of a payload. Please subscribe to our channel, and for more information about VMRay, go to VMRay.com.